With roots going all the way back to Muhammad Ali, I'm at Windy City Boxing Club here on Chicago's South Side, talking to Montell Griffin, who is the current owner of Windy City Boxing. And we're going to talk about his journey and how he gives back to kids in the community and how his dad and him used to hang out with Muhammad Ali. That's now on the Chicago scene. Let's go say hi. All right, I made it downstairs to Windy City Boxing Club with Montell Griffin. How you doing, sir?
Doing fine. How you doing?
I'm good. So you are, to say that you're the owner of this is just understating a little bit, because you're the real deal. You've been in the ring. You have boxed for the United States of America, right? Tell me about it.
Yeah, I was a 1992 Olympian with only 30 amateur fights. And then I turned pro. I beat James Toney after 14 pro fights. I beat him again. Then I got a win against Roy Jones, the great fighter that he is. So I did pretty good. I had 50 wins, 30 knockouts, but 8 losses, which is a few was controversial, but it is what it is. But yeah, I love the game, and I just tried to give them all.
30 wins via knockout. That's incredible. That's not a small feat at all. And you're 5'7", so it's kind of a big deal. You're a little bit, you're a lightweight heavyweight, right? Is that right?
Light heavyweight. I'm a short light heavyweight.
And you've had boxing in your blood, because you were telling me earlier that your dad, Clarence, opened up the original Windy City Boxing Club, right?
Yeah, he opened up the original Windy City Boxing Club at 1154 East 63rd Street in 73. And he ran it for 10 years until he passed away.
And your dad, I mean, you and your dad, I mean, he had, I mean, the greatest athlete, arguably, of all time. Muhammad Ali walking through the halls and talking to you and all the whole thing, right?
Yeah, Muhammad Ali lived in Hyde Park, like 10 minutes from the gym. So he always tell his my father, like, when I come in town, can I come train? And, of course, my father said yes. And
you're not going to say no to Muhammad Ali, right?
Every day he called and said he was on his way. By the time he got there, it'd be 100 people there. I don't know how, but it'd be 100 people there. He would train, interact with everybody. It was the greatest experience of my life. And just to show you an example, every time we would leave the gym, Ali would say, come ride with me. And I look at my father, he said, go ahead.
Yeah.
And I said, why you always make me go with him? He said, champ, you don't even understand what this is right now. And now I understand, you know what I'm saying?
You had no idea the magnitude of who Muhammad Ali was.
Muhammad Ali, but at 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, I thought everybody saw Muhammad Ali. I didn't know that I was blessed like that.
You remember the kind of car Muhammad Ali was driving through the streets of Chicago?
No, I rode with Rolls Royce. He had a Stutz Bearcat.
Sure.
I rode in that car with him. It was just a great experience.
That's an incredible story. And sadly, your dad passed and the gym closed, right? In like, what, 73?
Well, no, he ran it to 83.
Yeah, I'm sorry, 83.
A few owners took it over, and it closed like 10 years ago. But as you see, I reopened it, and I reopened it with my father's name, Clarence Griffin.
Yeah,
the city
yeah, right
club,
there.
Because I want his name, you know what I'm saying, to live on forever.
So just real quick, you were in Chicago, your dad passed, you fell in some hard times, you went out to L.A., and that's kind of how you got your start. A year later, you were boxing again, and then you had this career, and then the career wind down as people get older, right? And then you made your way back to Chicago, and you opened up this space about 3 years ago?
3 years ago. We've been over 3 years in Lacuna Lofts on the south side, low ends, South Loop area. And it just was meant to be in my life. I mean, this was meant for me. This is how I was supposed to, live my life. Like I said, I reopened the gym, and I'm trying to get back to the kids. I work with After School Matters. I have my own nonprofit, Windy City Boxing Youth Foundation, where I give out 30 scholarships to kids every month. So we're just trying to, do some good things and help the children.
That's incredible. And did you say you give out about 30 a month?
Yeah, 30 scholarships.
That's incredible.
So kids come in and train. So it's working out pretty good.
And this is important to you. I mean, this was your dad started this. You had that love of boxing that now you get to carry on. Your own kids could mess around in the rink a little bit, right?
Right, yeah. My daughter, she wanted to box. I didn't let her. So she's playing pro ball in Bosnia right now. She actually leading the league in scoring. And my son, he fought a few amateur fights, but he has academic scholarships, so I don't mind if you don't box and go to school.
And you put all this in your passion to teach boxing, and then also you got yourself a book, right?
Yeah, The Ice Life. I wrote a book. I started writing in 2006. I ended up, finishing with it, a little bit like last year. So it's The Ice Life. You can reach it. The link is theicelifebook.com. It's just a story about a kid. I wasn't the greatest fighter of all time. I don't have the best life, but it's about a kid who made a second chance for his life. I quit boxing at 13 years old, and 8 years later, I came back and it took me 1 year to make the Olympic team. So I'm really proud of that.
That's incredible in itself. So boxing, in essence, turned your life around or helped save your life, right? And that's what you're trying to do with these kids in the neighborhood, to kind of just put them on the right path, right?
Right, right. So I'm just trying to get kids to come get off the streets. You know, we got a lot of violence in Chicago. You know, put the guns down, put up the gloves. And, you know, it's the greatest therapy in the world.
And the book is a culmination of your life events, right? And is that your name? Is that why? Was that your name, your nickname?
Yeah, Ice Life. Montell Ice Griffin, a friend of mine, Brian Cooper, gave me the nickname. And Eddie Futch made a big deal about my trainer. And so he said I was so cool under pressure. So it kind of got famous for that. So, yeah, Montell Ice Griffin and my book, The Ice Life. Theicelifebook.com is the link. Check it out. I'm sure you will be impressed.
Montell, thank you very much for your time. I appreciate letting me come inside and crash the party that you are. I'll let you get back to training because I feel like I'm taking time away from you. All right, we'll see you later.
I needed a break anyway.
All right, there you have it from the founder, Montell Griffin, here at Windy City Boxing Club in Pilsen neighborhood, TBARNAS at WGNTV.com, TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene, until then, get back to training. I'm going to get out of the way.